All right, so for the soldering here, what I'm going to do is, actually for pinning the motor, I have the motor on these pliers here. And I just want to make sure, there is some solder on it already, but I just want to make sure that there's enough. So I'm either just remelting it or applying just a bit more solder. The next thing now is to actually attach the ESC motor cables to the motor itself. And for this, you're going to have to pay attention to which wires go where. On the motor, you can see it's labeled A, B, C going this way. On the ESC, you can see on the housing, if you bend these wires down, I don't know if I can get a, no. But if you look on the housing here, you'll see some letters A minus B plus C. So A, B, C, and then the power cables, right? So because of the way it's oriented like that, I'm actually going to turn the ESC upside down like this, so that I have A, B, C going into the motor this way. Right? Yep. So now that both things are tinned here, this should be a much easier process. Now, so I'm just applying a little bit of pressure on the cable into its slot there, and then applying the heat to both surfaces. Okay. Now, normally I wouldn't apply the heat source to both surfaces like that, but because this is such a tight fit like this, you gotta work with what you have, right? So again, for this other one, this does get a little hot, so I recommend some pliers. Okay, I'm just waiting for the solder to flow, and then I'm removing the heat. Again, because the cables are so thick here, you're going to have to keep the heat on a little longer than ideal. But actually, this one I'm going to try heat from the top down. There you have it.